admit, I'm not in politics.
Yes.
I'm a mother, I'm a wife, I'm a busy person. It is a bit confusing and overwhelming to understand all that it entails. For someone who may not even be willing to admit it right now, can you just break it down to the least common denominator?
I'll be happy to break it down. The fact of the matter is you are a mom. You want to be a part of the dynamic region. You happen to have a very successful career, and you're on the leading radio station in the state. But over the last 10 years, our region has lost more than 200,000 jobs. We've only added about 300,000. So that means a region with 5.5 million people only have a net gain of about 100,000 jobs. That's terrible. And what that means for people who are not like you is they're tethered to the job that they have because there aren't multiple opportunities anymore. So when they go to work, folks are going to work on pins and needles because you've got to worry about losing the job you have. That's fundamentally unhealthy and not what our city has traditionally been about. When I was in the job market, I used to get phone calls about joining other law firms at the end of every month. And I knew that if I lost my job, I would have multiple job opportunities. You all don't have that right now. You have a lot of folks in this room right now who've purchased homes. And if you were to walk outside of your door and put a for sale sign in your yard, you'd be lucky if you could sell the house in 6 months, and you'd be lucky if you broke even. Most folks would actually lose value in their homes. But what does that have to do with transportation? The reason that we are losing the competition for corporate relocation is because folks talk about our traffic. And when major corporations are making a decision about where to bring their employees, they don't want their employees bogged down in traffic with a poor quality of life. That's why we're losing. There's a reason that a rock-rear Republican conservative government and a Democratic mayor who fights for President Barack Obama every single chance I get are joining together to try to pass this referendum. The reason is we're in the same meetings where we're losing competitions that we would have won easily just 4 years ago. So we've got to take on the issue of traffic so that other cities, when they're competing against us, can't use that against us anymore. But what's going to happen when that happens? You're going to see more businesses locate in Atlanta. You're going to have many more options. And your real estate values are going to stabilize because people will be moving to the region again. So we're going to take on traffic, and that will mean investing about $600 to $800 million a year in the metro region every single year. Now think of it, folks. We only invested $3.5 billion for the Olympic Games. Literally almost three times the economic impact of the Olympic Games. So if you're a person who came to Atlanta or is from Atlanta that had a dream or a vision, you're going to have a dynamic environment again to pursue your dream and your vision. That's why Atlanta is what it is. I mean, when you think about where we are, you all, Atlanta doesn't have a beautiful ocean that you get to run to at lunch. It doesn't have beautiful mountain vistas that you get to go check out at lunch. But for whatever reason, we were the third fastest growing metro region in the United States of America over the last 10 years. The reason is you all. It's our people. We continue to attract smart, highly trained, well-qualified people. And that's why we have the third largest amount of Fortune 500 companies located here. They come here because of you. But I tell you what, they won't keep coming if they can't get you in and out of work on time.
Right.
And every single day, y'all can clap for that. City of Atlanta has 500,000 people in it. Every single morning between 5:30 and 9 o'clock, the population doubles to 1 million people. So we've got to be able to get folks into the city, let them work and earn a living, and then get them out and back home. We're losing about 60 hours a year in traffic. And that's time that you would be with your newborn. You really got to think of it that way. And then folks say, well, it won't cut enough time off of my career. You don't know what you're talking about. If the problem gets worse and worse and worse, your commute's gonna grow and grow and grow. So you gotta fight constantly to keep the times where they are or lower. Now we have a plan to create the Atlanta July, which is gonna be really special to people who live in Atlanta. And it's gonna help traffic because it's gonna take in-town drivers off of the street. If you go outside right now, the only vertical construction you will see are apartment buildings. Because young people aren't interested in buying a house. They want to live in town, and they want to commute to work in a fashion that's convenient for them. This whole conversation about the transportation referendum is really for old people. Because young people are gone. They don't even understand why we're talking about whether we should have light rail and last mile connectivity. Young people aren't even that interested in cars, for goodness sakes. Every trend shows that young people are actually moving away from cars. So what we're doing in Atlanta is we're betting on the future. And this is going to be a very tough vote because when the vote is being held. If this vote was being held in November, I would have DJ E-Class playing right now as opposed to me up on the stage. But it's being held in the
You know, change is necessary, but it's uncomfortable for many people. I mean, but sometimes you got to force it, you got to push it. And I thought it was interesting how you said, you know, what happens when you spend an hour or 2 hours in traffic every day? It affects your quality of life. And truth be told, the reason, one of the strong reasons why we left the New York City area, I live 6 miles away from my job, but it took me an hour and 40 minutes to get to work. And another hour and 40 minutes to get home every day. That's no quality of life. You know, and that's because the city is over congested. Now, I read that it's predicted, already the city of Atlanta has 5 million people, but it's predicted in the next 15 years or so that it could almost double because of migration, because people who are in the counties, tired of the traffic, moving closer to the city. Well, yeah. That's
true.
Thank you. Did you hear that?
You want to
say it again?
I said people are going to come here, eat your
dog. Thank you. but if we don't pass this, will we be equipped for that growth? And if we do, if you're talking about the next 15 years or so, will we be ready as a city for that type of congestion?
Well, you know, I mean, I appreciate your point, but one of the things that I say to myself all the time is disruption is the companion of the city. I can't be comfortable or at peace. I always have to be looking to make this city better, to do more, to create more opportunities. And to be honest, Egypt, this is just a baby step towards where Atlanta and the region needs to go. This is going to get us comfortable with this kind of path. The fact of the matter is this referendum should have been a 20-year referendum for double the amount of money we spent, but the politics in this state won't allow that. It's going to change your lives. I want to be real clear on what it's going to do for young people in this region. It's going to make this region far more dynamic and robust with more opportunities than I had when I was in the same position that you were, which is why I'm working so hard for it. We have spent $900 million with women and minority-owned businesses. That means over about a 4-year period of time that we continue to do what we do, we will spend $3 billion by the time we're done with women and minority-owned businesses. We really think that that's what we're about. We do more of that than any major comparably sized city in the United States of America. And we think that that's a real key to the success of events like tonight.
I love that you keep using the word we.
No question.
Not I.
No.
We, because you know, I think that's a message that resonates throughout this room. Every decision made, it's about us as a family. We are a family. You know, the city, I just explained to them, I just landed on Atlanta in March. Your reputation precedes you as the people's mayor. You are very loved, one of the most loved mayors in the country. I don't know if you guys realize that. And you have a reputation for attacking the issues that most would shy away from. But I'm still gonna get you losing that time.
Just go ahead.
So now you said you're 43 years old.
Yes.
But no way.
I'll tell you what.
why not married yet?
I think that continue, first of all, I was never going to marry before I was 30. And then
that's something you decided.
Oh, period. I mean, you know, Gabrielle Union couldn't have gotten me married before I was 30. No, I like Gabrielle Union more than I do.
Okay.
The point I'm there, I mean, you know, everybody got their own thing, but the point I'm there. Social media is different. I'm happy for her in any way, I was happy. The point I'm making is by the time I was 30 to 40 was a brutal year. And I don't care who you are, you can't break in so many ways. So since I have been there, I've had a more stable and calm life. And I think I moved in the right direction. But between 30 and 40, I wanted to be mayor of Atlanta since I was 13 years old. I was a partner in the law firm by the time I was 33. I was managing the mayoral campaign as the first female mayor in the history of the city of Atlanta, and I had other priorities.
So it's safe to say you were married to your career.
No, it's safe to say that my career was terrible on relationships and destructive relationships. Okay. And if there was something, if it was my career, or the person I was dating at the moment I chose my career. So I paid a price for that. But I've had some happiness along the way.
So let's talk reality TV then. There are a lot of programs filming out of Atlanta right now. What do you think of reality TV, number one, and the content that you've seen thus far coming out of Atlanta?
Well, you know, I think Atlanta is certainly Black Hollywood and it's a medium there. And is the home for more African-American themed television shows, not just reality shows, but television shows, period, than any other city in America. So I have different feelings about different shows. But I like anyone, you know, if you have a significant other or girlfriend, you have to watch a certain amount of reality shows.
Okay, so
Team
Stevie or Team Crappy, I'm joking. So, all right, you want to get serious, you want to talk about the transportation.
Okay,
we're going